If you have understood octahedral, octahedral splitting, you should be able to understand tetrahedral. But of course, the problem being it's tetrahedral, the angles are different. Octahedral, good thing it was, on dz square you have one orbital clearly, and the ligands are coming from there. Dxy, x and y direction ligands are coming directly. But in tetrahedral, you see the orbitals in somewhere, the ligands are coming from somewhere. It's not like head-on collision. It's not exactly direct approach of the ligand, I mean direct overlap of the ligand and orbital are not happening. That is where, of course, you should be able to understand the destabilization will not be that much. So the splitting, of course, there will be splitting also in the d orbital. Splitting extent to which the splitting will occur will not be too much, because in octahedral it's a head-on collision. Bang. In tetrahedral it's going to be side-on, just touching and going, almost kissing and running away, right? So that is where you will see in tetrahedral you will never have any low spin configuration. Means the extent of separation between T and E, or in this case we don't say T to G and E G, we say T2 and E, okay, same dxy, dyz, dxz is T2, E not EG, E is dx2, y2, dz2, okay, will come. Since octahedral, we are saying that of course 6 of the ligands are approaching. In tetrahedral, only 4 of them are approaching. In octahedral, it's a head-on collision. In tetrahedral, it is, just sidewise, you can say, or very little collision, very little good overlap. The repulsion from the ligand or ligand electron will not be able to repel the metal electron that efficiently as you see in the octahedral case. So the splitting, repulsion is this, that splitting is nothing but difference between E and T2, whatever we are saying. This 3 orbital versus 2 orbital splitting, the distance. So that is never going to be too high. If it is not too high, if it is always like this, at let us say room temperature, the electron can access all of them. So it is always going to be high spin. We do not have to worry about low spin in tetrahedral case. Only in octahedral case we have to think about low spin and high spin, okay, clear? The reason is very simple, number of ligands are less, so repulsion is less, 4 versus 6, 4 ligands versus 6 ligand, tetrahedral means 4 ligands, and also the approach of the ligand with respect to the orbital is not going to be direct, it is almost a side approach, okay. Now, so the ligands, as you can see, occupying alternate orbital over here, occupy alternate corner, 1, 2, 3 and 1 in the back, 4 ligands, right. You imagine just methane CH4, how the hydrogens are with respect to carbon. Imagine carbon is your metal center and 4 hydrogens are your 4 ligand, that is how it is, right. It is not octahedral, it is tetrahedral. So E orbitals we will be calling E orbitals and T2 orbitals, okay. So here they are. In this case, actually I'll say you why it will be. In this case, it is the reverse of octahedral. These are going to be stabilized, DG2 and DX2Y2 are going to be stabilized, because these orbitals are the ones which will be facing this ligand least. So ligand is here, ligand is there, ligand is there and ligand is there. Can you see the 4 ligands, four black dots, strong dots, 1, 2, 3, 4. See the dz square orbital and dx2 orbital, y2 orbital, these two orbitals are facing the ligand least, they are farthest from the ligand. that means the repulsion will be less, or they are the one which is going to be stabilized. If you think about the octahedral, of course from the free metal ion everything destabilized, and from there further stabilized and further destabilized, right. Over here the pattern is just opposite. 3 2 was for octahedral, it will be 2 3. E will be the stabilized one, T2, not T2G, mind you, not EG again, E and T2, these are coming from symmetry elements which will not be taught. So it is like this. So these two orbitals are stabilized, these three are destabilized, relatively destabilized. See, once again, these are the four ligands, 1 2 3 4. These four ligands are, with respect to this, it is more close to the orbitals. These ligands are close to these orbitals more compared to these. You just see, look at the angle, how far they are, you will be able to see it. Okay. It is going to be little bit twisted from octahedral, because octahedral it was clear cut. Tetrahedral you have to see that 109 angle, right. That is the angle between the two ligands going to be, right. Now these are the one, these d orbitals are the one which is going to be destabilized compared to these two. That is because they are facing the ligand more efficiently, or their ligand electrons and metal electrons are going to repel each other more strongly because they are coming too close to each other compared to that we see in here. Clear? You see it, it should be fine. Now also, just numerically speaking, you can see that the E orbitals are, of course, 109 angle total if you see the geometry, and it is two of them. So it is 54 degree with respect to the center. You can come look at, if it is not clear you can come back, I will just. T2 is nearer to the ligand, hence higher energy. E is farther from ligand, then thereby lesser energy. I think this picture gives you the clear idea where the ligands are and where the orbitals are. It is a 3D view. No amount of explanation will not be good enough. You have to look at. I cannot explain perfectly. You have to look at. Okay. Now, so if you look at delta G and delta T, in delta 0, it, I meant actually delta octahedral. Delta T means delta tetrahedral. This is the splitting. Okay. Now this splitting, delta 0 will be very high, that is what we are saying, compared to delta T. What is the reason? Once again, 4 ligand versus 6 ligands. You have 6 ligands for octahedral, you have 4 ligands for tetrahedral. Thereby the delta T will be less, delta 0 or delta octahedral is always going to be more. Okay. Now what is the extent? And also you have seen E below, T2 up. Now overall, this is the one you have to kind of remember. It is like 2/3 and 2/3. Why 2/3 and 2/3? So 4 9, where is that coming from? So 4 ligands versus 6 ligands. 6 times 2/3 is going to be 4 ligands. 6 ligands was for octahedral, 4 ligand is for tetrahedral. So 2/3 number of ligands, 2/3 times 6 is 4. There is a component of 2/3, and there is this, roughly due to the angle, since they were colliding head on, and here it is a 109 degree angle is there, and thereby how the orbitals are oriented towards the ligand, that gives you another 2/3. Means what I am saying is the extent to which ligand in octahedral case is interacting versus extent to which tetrahedral is interacting, overall that is going to be 4 9 of delta 0. Delta octahedral is always going to be higher compared to delta tetrahedral for a, let us say, given metal complex. You have Ml4, Mn6, same metal, same ligand, everything else, oxidation states stay same. So tetrahedral, that destabilization or the splitting is always going to be less. How less? It is 4.9 times delta 0, where the 4.9 is coming from? 2/3 times 2/3, 2/3 times 2/3, 2/3 due to the number of ligands, 6 times 2/3 is 4, another 2/3 due to the angle of approach, how it is coming. Okay, anyway, that is what I was trying to tell. All tetrahedral complexes are high spin because the splitting is less. Understood? Octahedral and tetrahedral, completely different scenario. T2g lower, eg up. Here e, not eg, okay, e lower, t2 up. That is all you need to know. Now let us go. So as you see, now you look at these values, we were saying 20,000, 25,000, so on, for this delta, delta octahedral. Delta tetrahedral is always very small in number. If you now go back and look at the corresponding, let us say, octahedral complex, you will be able to see that these are lower in number. 5 minutes. So if you now compare the stability or overall between octahedral and tetrahedral, if it is 0 electron, no stability, let us say we are not talking. If it is 1 electron in the octahedral case, the blue line is for octahedral, ligand field stabilization energy plot versus number of electrons plot. So if you have 1 electron, it is going to be in T2g1 for octahedral case, it is going to be 0.4. If you have 2 unpaired electron, it is going to be 0.8 or 8 dq or 0.8 delta 0. We are talking 4 dq, 10, 8 dq. If it is 3, it is 12 or 1.2 delta 0. Similarly, you can start putting for tetrahedral. Tetrahedral, it is E1, not T, E1, E2. E1 is going to be 6 delta T. If that 6 delta T you multiply by 4.9 of delta 0, which that 4.9 term, you will be able to see that this is the actual difference. This plot actually makes complete sense. 5 unpaired electron, if we are talking all high spin versus high spin, octahedral high spin, tetrahedral high spin we are comparing. 5 unpaired electron high spin in octahedral means T2g3, Eg2, 0, total 0. 3 of them are in here, 2 of them are in here, so 0. In octa, in tetrahedral, it is always high spin, E2, T2, 3, right? So it is once again going to be 0. Okay, that is how, for as the number of electron increases, how the high spin case ligand field stabilization energy is varying, you will be able to understand. I think we are losing the concentration, I am with you, just 1 or 2 minutes, I will not take too much. Okay, now, so let us look at this one. If you understand little bit of this one, I think I will let you go today. Okay, anything you pick up, 3 unpaired electron, number of electrons is 3, number of 3 unpaired electrons or 3 electrons, D3 configuration. For octahedral case, it is what? T2g and Eg, it is going to be 1, 2, 3, T2g3 and Eg0. T2g3 means each of them are having 4 dq stabilization. So it is going to be minus 12 dq or minus 1.2 delta 0 or delta octahedral, that is the stabilization energy. Okay, that is over there. Now you talk about tetrahedral. Tetrahedral case, 3 electron, it is going to be E and T2, E2, T2, 1, E2, T2, 1, E2 means 6 plus 6, 12 dq stabilization. If it is 3 electrons, 1, 2, 3, it is never going to pair up. Unless there is no option, then it will pair up. It is never high spin, low spin situation. It is always high spin situation. 1, 2, 3. Each of them are 6 delta T, not delta O, delta T. So, two of them are 12 delta T. One of them is 4 delta T. Minus 12 plus 4. Minus 8. Minus 8 delta T. Now, that is tetrahedral. How much it is in terms of octahedral? Multiplied by 4 9. So, apparent close to 4. 4 delta O, right? Yeah, most of you got it. So, minus 6 times 2 plus 4 delta T, that is going to be for E2 T2 1. This is going to be for tetrahedral E2 T2 1 electronic configuration. Overall, how much it is? It is going to be minus 8 delta T. Now, as you know, minus 8 delta T means minus 8 delta T means this is time 4 by 9 for overall, this is going to be in delta 0, right. So, it is nearly going to be, let us say 3.8 or 3.9, whatever it is. 9 and 8 cancel out, or whatever it is, 32 divided by 9, right. So, now you look back in here, 3.8 or so. So, that is how each of the electronic configuration, once again mind you, this is high spin. Tetrahedral is always high spin. Tetrahedral high spin versus octahedral high spin we are trying to compare. You should be able to do this plot by yourself. Okay. If you think you have understood this class, or if you after studying 10 minutes, 15 minutes, whatever it takes you, or 1 hour, whatever it takes you, after studying it, if you can plot this one, I think that will reflect that you have understood the delta 0 and delta T business. Okay. Now, there is another term which is called octahedral site stabilization energy. What is that? That is nothing but the same electronic configuration or same electron number, if it is given for octahedral versus it is given for tetrahedral, what is the stabilization, net stabilization? Let us say net stabilization. This is 2 electron stabilization for octahedral, this is 2 electron stabilization for tetrahedral. What is the difference between the two? You will never see that octahedral is less stable compared to tetrahedral. It is always octahedral is more stable. How much stable? That is what is usually called octahedral site stabilization energy, OSSE. It is perhaps not discussed in the class. So, you can understand the difference for the same type of electron or same electronic configuration, how much stability octahedral is going to get compared to tetrahedral. Okay. But mind you, again, this is the comparison between the high spin, tetrahedral high spin, tetrahedral is always high spin, octahedral high spin. But sometimes this octahedral site stabilization energy can differ. Sometimes tetrahedral is more stable if octahedral stabilizes, octahedral that crystal field stabilization energy becomes less. That can happen if it is, let us say, scenarios will be there where you can have such thing. We will discuss those. Okay. So, those next topic will be spinel, normal spinel. Spinels are what? Spinels are nothing but the gems, what you see. Okay. These are different metal oxides with the form Ab2O4, magnesium, aluminium, one magnesium, two aluminium and four oxygen. Different of these, you know, the jewels that you see, different rocks, these are nothing but spinel. spinels are of two types, normal spinel and inverse spinel. This is the only topic that is left for this chapter, coordination complex. So the class is over.